In a hadith authenticated by Sheikh Nasruddin al-Albani alayhi rahmatullah, every single book revealed by Allah unto any prophet was revealed in Ramadan. Today is an introduction to Ramadan. Next week we'll break the books and all these things. Every single book, Suhuf Ibrahim alayhi salam, was sent in Ramadan. Musa alayhi salam was given the Torah in Ramadan. That's why Allah commanded him to fast. Isa alayhi salam was given the Injil when? In Ramadan. Dawood alayhi salam was given Az-Zabur in Ramadan. And our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received Al-Quran in Ramadan. In Ramadan. Every single prophet from our father Adam till our prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they all received their books in Ramadan. In the month of the humanity spiritual thirst. Ramadan is not about not eating food. Ramadan is about me acknowledging that my nafs, my soul is thirsty. I am thirsty. And the only thing to quench my thirst in this month is Al-Quran. That's why our scholars, the Sahaba, even Rasulullah when the month comes, it's the month of Al-Quran. If you approach the month of Ramadan this year with the intention that I am thirsty and I need, and in the building to Ramadan, every Wednesday I will give you, we're going to work so that we maximize to the top with this Ramadan this year. Ramadan this year is not going to be a regular Ramadan. Ramadan. What time is it now? Okay, good. Ramadan. I'm going to start here to the left and I'm going to say one. This is day one of Ramadan. And we're going to assume here is day 30 of Ramadan. You see, a lot of people, including us, when Ramadan starts, we are all energized and we're going to do that, right? Comes the 21 day, oh come on, well, when is Ramadan going to end? We start losing gas. We are no longer. And you see, the number of people in the masjid starts diminishing. It's because people do not understand the thirst. When do you quench your thirst? At the beginning or at the end of the bottle? The end. A lot of people miss the end of the bottle. A lot of people miss the great quench because they abandon drinking before the end of the bottle. Remember, this is about water. And water is to make you life. I will tell you something, my brothers. Why does Islam put such an emphasis on the last 10 days? Last 10 days. Or last 10 nights of Ramadan. And then, why does Islam put an emphasis on the odd nights? Why? Yes, but why? Okay, Laylatul Qadr is what 100 billion of Muslims would say, Laylatul Qadr. But what it is in Laylatul Qadr? What makes Laylatul Qadr so special? In it was raised what? What was sent in it? Al-Quran. Right? But what is the purpose of Al-Quran? It's to quench that thirst, right? A lot of people have already spent 20 nights in Ramadan. And Ramadan has not impacted their lives. You with me, my brothers? You see now how your brain is trying to get to that thinking? You see how the thinking is changing? That's how the Sahaba got it, my brother. It's not this watered down Islam today. Ramadan is coming, come on, fasting, and that's it, and the masjid read Quran. People read Quran for the number of times, but you know how they do it? Usually in 10 minutes they will read 5 pages. When Ramadan comes, what happens is, they read in 10 minutes, 20 pages. They just go fast. Ramadan is not impacting their lives. This is not the purpose of Ramadan. Ramadan, my brothers, is for this. The first 20 days or 20 nights are a build-up to appreciate the last 10 nights. If you will, the first 20 days of Ramadan is we preparing for a race, for the marathon. The marathon is on the last 10 nights. We don't lazy around and then suddenly we go run, right, or play a soccer game. We don't do that. We have to train and we have to do everything. And then the competition. Competition day for us Muslims comes in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. The 20 days are a build-up for the people who are not used to waking up, for the people who are not used to reciting Quran, for people who are not used, they have a chance to practice here. Then when it comes in the last 10 days, look at how smart Islam is. Allah doesn't put pressure on us. He gives us one night, work very hard. The other night, relax. The even night, relax. The odd night, work. The even night, relax. You see? On, off. Why? What does Allah want for us? Why does Islam drive us to behave the way we behave? Because Allah says, Allahu Akbar. On the last 10 nights, Allah could have said Laylatul Qadr is the night of 27. And you see a lot of people, there's 27 and the end of it, they don't show their faces because they've done the job wrong. Allah, why He hid when is Laylatul Qadr? And Laylatul Qadr is the misunderstood night in history. Laylatul, here, remember we've been building up, then there is the big reward. What is the big reward? The big reward is when you meet Laylatul Qadr, is that in that night when you are standing to Salat, appreciating the Quran and the quench and all that concept, you will resemble in your status the status of Al-Malaika who accompanied Al-Quran the very first night when it came down. When the Quran was sent to Rasulullah, don't you ever think Jibril brought the Quran to the first heavenly guest, let's say. Al-Malaika, it was a special ceremony to bring Al-Quran from Al-Lawh al-Mahfuz to the first heaven. Every year, Al-Malaika, including Jibril, celebrate the event. Every year. Every year they celebrate the event when? Laylatul Qadr. Jibril doesn't come on earth except in Laylatul Qadr. Do you see what I mean, my brothers? This is no night like the other nights. Isn't that Bara? Jibril, تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَ الْمَلَائِكَ all the angels come down to earth. Our Sahaba, our scholars say, if Allah gave us the eyesight, we will not be able to move on earth of the number. Every Laylatul Qadr, when you are walking in the street, the angels avoid you. So many of them. We don't see them. When you are standing in the masjid praying, you don't know how many Malaika are standing with you to pray. Al-Malaika, they come on earth not to play, to grandify, to worship Allah. In a hadith sahih in al-Jama' al-Saghir, al-Albani alayhi rahmatullah authenticated the hadith, and before him Suyuti and many others, Rasulullah says, when one of us, in the meaning, when one of us stands up for salat, as you start reciting al-Quran, يَدْنُو مِنْكَ مَلَكْ, an angel comes forth. You are standing, you don't see him. You're standing, the angel comes down close to you, and then he opens his mouth and puts his mouth around yours. Every ayah, every word of Al-Quran that you recite goes inside him. Goes inside him. Hadith sahih. Because Al-Quran, to Allah Al-Quran, the value of Al-Quran to Allah, it's enough to say it's the word of Allah. It's enough to say it's what? When you recite Al-Quran, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً, I have spoken the same words Allah spoke. Can you imagine that? You speak, my brothers, don't ever think Al-Quran is a book. Allah, no, Allah speaks Al-Quran to Jibreel. Jibreel hears the Quran with his ears, takes it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recites it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just like Allah spoke it, without changing a word. When you say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, you have just said the same words as Allah. It's no easy job. This Quran, Allah says, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل, if this mountains, buildings, skyscrapers, if Allah would let us, their effect, when they hear the Quran, they will all fall. But the man, he hears the words of Allah and doesn't care. We recite the words of Allah and you don't understand them. We recite the words of Allah and you don't follow them. Al-Quran comes, Ramadan comes every year to remind us of our original thirst. We're thirsty. Al-Quran is the only thing on earth that is going to quench that thirst. So, Laylatul Qadr is the reward for those who spent all these nights of Ramadan working hard. My brothers, it is Allah who authorizes us in Laylatul Qadr. People think, tonight it's odd nights, yes, it's the night of the 21. I'm gonna, let's say, pray. Alhamdulillah, blah, blah, blah. Allah knows what's in our intention. Allah knows. He knows why you're standing up there. This year, we will not stand. This year, we will not stand in the needy. Ya Allah, give me wealth. Ya Allah, give me a wife. No. Laylatul Qadr was never meant to be a night of I pay you wages. Laylatul Qadr is you showing to Allah that you are worthy of His forgiveness. You know, when we do an action, all we are doing is showing to Allah that we are worthy. لَأُرِيَنَّ اللَّهَ مِنِّي خَيْرٌ, a woman said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَأُرِيَنَّ اللَّهَ مِنِّي خَيْرٌ, I will show to Allah from me a good. Do it. When you make dua, when you do any act, all you are doing is you are putting an application in front of Allah, and you say, Ya Allah, I have fulfilled what you have asked of me. Please consider my application. That's why, why do you think Nuh, he tells his people that I have nothing against you. If Allah wants to do something, He'll do it. I got no control over Allah. Do you remember this ayat in the Quran? Plenty of them. These people, the only one who promised his people something he did not have an authority. Yunus alayhi salam, when he tell his people, you don't believe in Allah 3 days. How did Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala teach him a lesson? The whale. You don't pretend, you don't take claim. You only put your application forth to Allah. How do I know I am accepted? When Allah gives you the opportunity to fast Ramadan, He's accepting the application. It's like He's saying, okay, come forth. You 20 days, you're working very hard. Allah says, you've shown me that you are worthy of Laylatul Qadr. I'm going to enable you. You work hard in Laylatul Qadr. Allah says, you've shown you are eligible for my maghfirah, and I will let you witness Laylatul Qadr, and I am going to give you to make that dua. And you make dua. And this is why, my brothers, before and the end of it all, nothing comes from me. Everything comes from Allah. And Ramadan comes to remind us of that reality. I am thirsty. My soul, my ruh, my nafs is thirsty. Where do I get the quench from? Al-Quran, which is the words of Allah. So my brothers, if tonight you go with this, Ramadan shifts me from the norm to the exception, and Allah named it Ramadan because humans will always be thirsty for divine guidance, if you can tonight take this and work on them until next week, you'll understand why Jibreel every year comes down to Rasulullah and he teaches him Quran. Jibreel, Rasulullah doesn't need to be taught Quran, does he now? Does he? No. So why Jibreel comes to him every year? To teach Rasulullah Quran, to study and to explain and things like that. Because we are, it doesn't matter how far you are in your taqwa and your iman, you always need Al Quran. You always need Al Quran. Even Rasulullah needs Al Quran. My brothers, let me ask you a question now. Does the word Ramadan now mean the same thing to it as you always have in the past? No. Huh, what do you think? No. Are you going to welcome Ramadan this year like you did before? No, that is the wrong answer. Better. We're going to welcome him better. Next week, bi-idhnillah, Allah has given us many pointers in the Quran on how to interact, to maximize. Wallahi razi, many of them. It's just us, again, we have not been exposed to these realities. And I will just end up this here, when Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala يقول عبد بن شرر إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. Everyone knows this one, right? تنزل. Why didn't he say تتنزل الملائكة? Why he تنزل الملائكة? الروح جبريل عليه السلام. There is a huge secret in this surah. A huge secret in this surah. But inshallah, we'll work. This Ramadan is coming. Bi-idhnillah, this Ramadan is going to be a completely different Ramadan than anything else. Bear in mind, it is here to shift you. Once it shifts you from the norm to the exception, it works with you for 30 days to make that exception becomes your new norm. And then the next 11 months, you leave them on that exception. To make it, it teaches you exception. 11 months to come, practice that exception until it becomes the norm. So that the next year when it comes, it will shift you to a new exception. A new exception, until you meet Allah and He is pleased with you. And Allah knows more, my brothers. Next Wednesday, inshallah, we'll carry on with another thing, with another aspect of Ramadan. So, if you have any questions, my brothers. It always pleases me when you don't have questions. It's either... Yes, it was always named Ramadan. When people started talking about Ramadan and they say it's the thirst and the heat, but when it comes in winter, there is no heat and there is no thirst, and the name still is Ramadan. Because Huna al-Quran predominantly bases its rulings on the spirituality. It doesn't matter. Winter comes, humans are still thirsty at guidance level. See? So Ramadan here is and actually when Allah took Because at the beginning of Ramadan, as we will see in the history of Ramadan, you could still not eat if you wanted to. It was optional at the beginning. I'll explain the history of Ramadan to understand that when Allah took away eating from us, it was not a punishment. You know what it was? It was more to help us fulfill the goal of our mission easily. I'll give you an example. If you are going to play football, it's a World Cup, okay? See, everything is internet, World Wide Web, okay? Let's say two teams, okay? You don't go and have a big Mexican or Indian curry with lots of food, and then you walk into the stadium an hour later and you go, we're going to win the World Cup. It's not going to happen, right? You will eat just enough to give you that strength to perform on an empty stomach so that you perform your best. Ramadan, not eating, is nothing else but a help from Allah to raise us higher so that we don't have to worry about food and things like that, and we focus all our thoughts towards the only one thirst, guide us, Al-Quran. So food is not a punishment, it's more of a service Allah does to us. So yes, it's always been called the Ramadan. Because in the hadith of Rasulullah, as we see next week, when he speaks about the dates when at-Tawrat were sent, he would say, and this is like Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim, the Suhuf Ibrahim were sent in the night of the 19th, and all of them came in the winter nights. So Ramadan at the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam was still named Ramadan. So yes, it is always been called Ramadan.
So you say we build up for the first 10 nights to the first 20 nights, we build up to for the last 10 days.
Yeah.
And then the last day, 10 days of the odd days,
yeah,
you go in and make dua, expect to know something.
That's okay. I will tell you. That's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when Ummuna Aisha in the Sahih Bukhari, she asked him, "Ya Rasulullah, what should I do if ever I meet Laylatul Qadr? If I fall in Laylatul Qadr?" Look, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, because Ramadan is all about guidance and thirst for guidance. Ask Allah for forgiveness. He didn't say ask him for money. He didn't ask him for a wife. He didn't ask him for what Ramadan is for. Guidance and forgiveness. That's all it is about. Yahi, as I started, if Allah gives you a life of the worst person, like Prince, and you die with 200 million in the bank, but you go with him, like him, who would want that? Wallahi, nobody would want to. But who would want to die after Allah has given a beautiful Ramadan and gave you a whole year of good connection with Allah, and you make a lot of istighfar and you feel so connected with Allah, and then you die? And let me tell you a reality, my brothers. We all are rich. Wallahi al-Azim, at this moment here, it doesn't matter how much money you got. You are rich. I'll ask you a question. Your name, Yahya, again, Muhammad. If someone, and I speak to you, okay, talk openly, anyone here. If someone walks to you right now and says, insult Allah and I give you £100,000. And I mean it. Insult Allah and I give you £100,000. Would you do it? Hassan, would you? So you already are rich £100,000. £1 million? You wear a cross for 7 days and you get for every day £1 million. So you already have £7 million. You see how rich we are? We see how rich we are? It's just shaitan materializes richness in the money. He doesn't let us see the other richness. We all are rich. We all are rich. The day you are willing to trade your iman for money, then you are totally broke. Ramadan teaches us that we all are rich And above all, we should guide ourselves to worship, please Allah, and the rest, bi-idhnillah, will be easy. I'll see you next week, my brothers. And next week I have some good stuff for you about Ramadan, because we want this year to have the best Ramadan, not ever, but the beginning of so many good Ramadans. Allah alam salaam nabiyyina Muhammad subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Jazakumullah khair.